1 and model 2, as I said, it is similar same slight variations. That's what I mean to say. Okay, so I'll start with module 2 today. Okay, is the screen visible, students? The PPT screen? Yes? Okay, see, I want reply today's and tomorrow's session because it is a quite basic session. So you have, if you have a book and a paper with you, that will be So moving on to module 2, as I said, it's a basic stuff. So we will be learning about two things: operators and control statements. So different control statements and different operators. So the elaborated syllabus I have just mentioned here, you can see. So we'll be dealing with operators, right? The different types of operators like arithmetic, bitwise, relational, Boolean operators, logical operators, right? Assignment operator, ternary operator, which is called as a question mark, right? And similarly, we will see control statements like selection statements, iteration statements, and jump statements. So there's different other control statements. So we'll see this in module 2. So today's agenda, I'm first dealing with what are the different types of operators in Java. The first half we will see first. And I'll deal with arithmetic operators with the example. See, students, as I'd already told you all, anything it is asked in programming language, give the explanation or list it followed with the program. Very much important. So that's what I am also doing here. First, let me tell you what are the different types of operators present in Java. So Java provides, any language you take, and not only Java, any programming language, it has got its own set of operators. As you all know, operator is just a symbol that has certain operations to be performed, right? See, if I give you plus, you all know that plus is an operator. What does plus do for me? What does plus do for me? Students.
It adds two numbers.
It adds two numbers. Or I can tell it adds two operands. If I go for normal programming languages, it adds two operands which is given to you, given to it, sorry. Right? So you all know every operator is just a symbol which works on operands to give me a better, what do you tell, a single value or to give a result, I can tell. Okay? So in Java, mainly the operators are divided into four groups. One is arithmetic, the other one is bitwise, the other one is relational, the other one is the logical operator, right? So arithmetic, bitwise, relational, and logical operators. We try to divide into four groups. So I have this picture for you which tells you what are the different types of operators. Hopefully, we'll be discussing in our forthcoming sessions. So, arithmetic operators, unary operators, assignment operators, relational operators, logical operators, ternary operator, bitwise, and shift operators. Actually, these are the different sets of operators present. But mainly, we have these four groups. Why? Because when I take arithmetic, unary and assignment will fall in my arithmetic operators only. When I take relational, it is a separate group. Logical and logical is also a separate group. When I take bitwise and shift, they fall under one category, right? We'll see how they fall under the single category, right? So these are the set of operators present in Java. So we'll be dealing all these operators one by one. So it might be some of the operators might look for you simple, but still you have to go through it because in the exams they may ask you any of the operators. So list the set of operators, explain anyone, or specifically they might ask, it depends. It depends on the program setup, sorry, the question paper setup. So today, I'm just dealing with the first one, the arithmetic operators. So as you all know, we know that the arithmetic operators, whatever we have studied in our mathematics, the same way we will also be using in our program. Right? The arithmetic operators are used in the mathematical expressions the same way that we are used in our arithmetic, algebra, whatever it is, mathematics. So when I talk about the arithmetic operators, you can just see these are the different arithmetic operators. Can you just see here? Plus, subtraction, that is addition. Then you have multiplication, right? Then we have division, we have modulus, then increment, decrement, okay? And then we have plus equals, minus equals, star equals, slash equals, percentage equals, right? So what are these? These are called as the assignment operators, right? So these are the assignment operators, arithmetic assignment operators, which we are talking about. Can you hear me, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so these are the operators which are there, which is known to you all as of my knowledge. Okay, so you all know that the operands of these arithmetic operators, whatever we are talking about, it should be of numeric type. So you know that numeric type means it could be an integer or it could be a float value. But this will not work on Boolean types. So I cannot use it on Boolean types, that is true or false. I cannot write true plus true is true. Like that I will not get. But I can use on character types, right? I think we have seen incrementing character value, CH++. In the last module, we had seen that. Why? Because character type in Java is a subset. Character type is like an integer only because it holds the ASCII value. Just remember that the operands for all these arithmetic operators is of numeric type. That is, it can be either a float or a integer. That means to say, when I talk about int, again you can see it is byte, short, int, long. When I talk about float, it is float and double. So 6 data types it can support, but not Boolean. To some extent, it can support char too. Okay, so you have to list them. So this is just an example which I am just giving you with respect to addition, subtraction, and that's quite simple to you. Addition, I need not have to tell you, right? So you can see the result 10 plus 2 will give me 12. Subtraction, 10 minus 8, 2 gives me 8. Okay, multiplication gives me 20. Division gives me 5. Okay, you can see that. The special thing which you should note is the modulus. Anybody knows what is this modulus operator, students? What does it do? What does it do, modulus operator? What does it do,
ma? Gives the reminder value.
Gives the reminder.
Gives the reminder after the, yes, after the division. So the difference between division and modulus, if you can see, division gives you the quotient, modulus gives me the reminder, right? Then we have increment, decrement. You all know by default, increment and decrement always increments the value or decrements the value by what? By what? By what? Increment or decrement by what? By what number?
One.
Yes. So by default, when I write plus plus, minus minus, it is 1. So I need not have to write explicitly 1. Hmm? Then we have the assignment operators like this. Plus equals to, minus equals to, star equals to, slash equals to, modulus equals to. So we'll see this in depth. Just try to understand the examples now. A plus plus, if I give, what does it mean if at all A is 10? What is the answer of A now? What will be the answer of A? A gets incremented by?
11.
So it is 11. When I give A minus minus, considering A equals to 10, what is the answer of A? What does A contain?
9.
It contains 9. Okay. Similarly, we have this assignment operators, right? So if at all, I think you all know, can anybody tell me what does this actually mean? A plus equals to 10. what does this actually mean to me or to the compiler? It is something like, can you just tell me instead of this what I could have written? Someone can just tell me instead of this what I could have written.
A equals to A plus 10.
Okay. So instead of writing that longer form, we have shorthand notation. And that shorthand notation is the assignment, compound assignment operators we call. Okay. These are the examples which has been given to you. So we will see in depth. Remember students, this is just I have given you as a sample, but when you write in your exams, it is a program again. Okay. So we will see. The arithmetic operators, whatever I stated here, is divided into groups again. Something like basic arithmetic operator, right? Then modulus operator, then increment decrement operator, right? Four groups. This is assignment operators. So we will see all these four groups one by one with program. So basic arithmetic operators, when I talk about, the basic ones are your plus, minus, star, right? Division, that is multiplication division. As you see, normally speaking, numeric data, how it works the same even in program. Sometimes the subtraction symbol, what we have, can be used as unary operator to negate a variable. Something like this. Suppose if I write A equals to minus B. If at all B is 10, what is A containing me? What is A containing? B is 10. Students, A equals to minus B, I can write like this. What does A contain now?
Minus 10.
Minus 10. Suppose if at all B was minus 10, what does A contain? What does A contain?
10.
10, right? So it is just negating a variable. Negating a variable means, it is just, negating, giving the reverse. If it is negative, it gives positive. If it is positive, it gives negative. Just negating it. That's what it means to say there. So one more thing that you have to notice here is, if I'm using division operator. So if I'm using the division operator on two integer operands, remember, you will get only the integral part. That's all. You will not get the fractional part. Suppose if I write 5 by 2, what is my answer? Actual answer is what, ma? Actual answer is what? Give me the actual answer.
2.5.
But in programming, it is not 2.5. The answer is only
2.
Only 2. So the integral part is retained, whereas the fractional part is discarded. If it is integer operands, but if it is float operands, then the fractional part will be retained. No problem. Okay. So we'll see that with an example. Similarly, the other thing that we have to notice, the modulus operator works on both integer and floating point. So if you could observe in your C, modulus works only on integers, but in Java, it works even on floating point types. No issues. Okay. No issues there. So it easily works. So this is just the observations that we made with the basic arithmetic operators. One is plus, minus, star, and division are there. Minus, that is a subtraction operator, can act as negating a variable, as a unary operator. So unary operator means it works on a single operand. Okay. It works on a single operand. And modulus works on both integer and floating. And when you have division operated on two integer operands, we get only the integral, but not the fractional. Okay. So we have a small program here. I want the answer from you all. Just look the program and give me the answer. As I ask, just look the program. Okay. I'm not tell you much about the program, as you all know the program. I'm just trying to work upon the arithmetic operators on integers. Okay. Can you all give me the output? Someone, one by one, should I call out names or will you give the answer? Okay, one second. I'll just call out names. Okay. Do we have Chetan in the group? In the class? Do we have Chetan in the class? Yes, no. No. Deepthi? Deepthi is there in the class? Geeta? Unmute it, then talk. Namita?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can you give me the first output? So I'm trying to print
A equals to 2, ma'am.
Okay.
And B equal to 6.
B equals to 6. Very good.
C equal to 1, ma'am.
C equals to 1. Why 1? Can you justify?
Because it is only division, ma'am. We are not taking about remainder part. We are not doing modulus.
Okay. B is now 6, right? 6 by 4. 6 by 4, right?
6 by 4. Yes, ma'am. So we'll get 1.5.
Ma'am, it's an integer value, ma'am. So, ma'am, we can't take floating point value. So 0.5 will be neglected. Yes.
It will be the integral part is considered, fractional is negated. What is 1? What is D?
B is minus, say 1 minus 2 we will get, ma'am. So minus 1.
Very good.
And E equal to 1, ma'am. Minus of minus 1. 1.
Okay. So you can observe here, we saw two things. One is the division, the integral part. Since the operands are integers, the integral part is related. And how minus can act as a unary operator. Okay, good, Namita. Thank you, Namita. Next example I have with respect to my doubles, that is floating point value. Just take some time to note it and give me the output. Okay, I'll call out the names. Padmashree.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, can you give me the output? Take your time, not a problem.
DA is 2, ma'am.
Think and give answer, it is double. It is double. Will it give only 2 or something else? Along with 2?
2.00000.
2.00. Right. 00. So we assign while writing, write 2.0, no problem. Okay, how about next?
6.0.
And you can now ask me, ma'am, here it is 3 and here it is DA is double. So as we saw one conversion rules, operand is double, the entire expression will be double. Is it so? And here you can see integer is assigned to double. What will happen here? What kind of conversion is happening? Integer is assigned to double.
Automatic conversion.
Automatic conversion. Because smaller is getting placed in larger. That's how it is. Okay, next ma'am. Padmashree. DC. DC. If you have calculator, that will be better.
Yes, ma'am.
And book. Pen and book, sorry. DC, Padmashree.
1.5, ma'am.
1.5, very good. DD?
Minus 0.5.
Minus 0.5, okay. DE?
Plus 0.5.
Just 0.5. This is how exactly you have to write. See, I have given some small example here. Some example I have given. You can have your own example, but illustrate it. That's it. Okay. Like this, you should write the program in the output. Next is about the program with respect to modulus operator. Do we have Pallavi in the class? Pallavi is there in the class? Yes. Can you guess the output for this?
X mod 10 equals to
okay. What is evaluated here?
4.
Huh?
That's 42, right? 2.
42 mod 10. Remember, mod 10 gives me the reminder. And you should tell, you should also remember that it works on both integer and floating. Yes. Next line. Next line of output.
Y mod 10 equals to 2.25.
Yes,
only
it clearly works. Right, no, it works on floating point. So it works on floating point too. It should be 2.25. Yes, thank you, Mahinas and Padmashri for the previous output. Right, so remember, modulus even works on floating point. Similar to it. See here, the remaining part is considered as the reminder, 0.25. That's it. Okay. This is about the modulus operator. Next, we have compound assignment operators. So, part of this compound assignment operators is nothing but to combine an arithmetic operation with an assignment. That's all. So, we are combining arithmetic, some arithmetic operation with assignment. Two things we are doing. We are doing one arithmetic operation, then assigning it. Okay. So, we can do this on all our arithmetic binary operators. All the binary arithmetic operators can be applied for compound assignment operators. So any statement of the form what we write, so we cannot write wherever we want, like that. Where, you can see, where equals to where op expression, right? So anything which is like this, I can easily write as what, ma? I can easily write as what? Where OP is equal to expression. OP is what, ma? The operator symbol. So I can easily write where OP equals to expression. Here I can, it can be anything here. Interesting. It's not necessarily an integer. Anything can be given there. An expression can be also be given. Okay. So if I have to write A equals to A plus 4, I could have written as A plus equals to 4. Very easy way. Shorthand notation it is. Okay. So, followed with this, we have a small program here. Fine. I'll give you 1 or 2 minutes. You can work on it. Give me the answers for ABC. You can give me the answers for ABC. Who will answer? Bhagya is there? Bhagya? Bhagya? No. Dheeraj? You can tell me yes or no, whether you can answer or you cannot answer.
Thank you.
No problem. Okay. Okay, who can give me the answer? At least volunteers. Maria,
A equals to 6.
Shreyas, one second, Shreyas. I'll go to the screen. Okay, tell me what A equals?
6, ma.
How is 6, ma?
Some increment of 5.
Okay, so this statement will be taken what by the compiler? A equals to?
A plus 1.
A plus 5. So which is now what now? As per your statement. Yes. Next, how about B?
b equals 8.
Is equal to 8. So what is the internal representation that the compiler takes? What is the internal representation? B equals to b
into 4.
Into 4. So that is b is 2 for me. So it is 8. Very good. About sigma. How about C? Stress?
3.
What is the value of C?
5.
Okay, give me what is the value of C here at this point of time? At this point of time, what is the value of C? Here.
6.
Here it is 6. Third line.
Three.
No, I don't want the final answer. I want what is the value of C here?
51.
3, ma'am.
Okay.
3, ma'am.
Oh. It's 3, ma'am.
3.
2, ma'am.
5. No. Here, what is the answer, ma'am? C three, plus ma'am. Equals to A star B.
Five.
See, I told you it can be
total
any
answer is
okay. How? Oh my god,
51 because already A and B value is 6 and 8, so it will be 14 plus 3.
Okay, see this expression, whatever is here. Okay, give me some time. One second. This expression, whatever is here, now will be treated like this. C is equal to C plus A star B. See, this is not now a normal integer or any value. It is an expression. So what is A to me? A is 6, 6 and 8. B is 8. 6 star 8. What is 6 star 8, ma? 40?
8.
48 has to be added to C. What is the existing value of C?
3, ma'am.
3. So what is my answer at this point of time?
51.
Remember, whatever is the value of C should be added to, whatever is the value of C should get added to A star B. So 3 plus 48, which is equal to 51 here, and then 51 will be taken by C. Now what is the answer here? Now
3.
What is the answer here at this point of time? 51 mod 6. So 51 mod 6 means, you know that it is 6 8 is 48, so 3 is the remainder. Remember, see, as I told you, you can have an expression also. This is an expression which gets added to the value of C. Are you understanding? So such kind of questions might come in your exams wherein you have to be careful while answering, right? Okay, next is about the increment and decrement operators. So we have the plus plus and minus minus. Two times when I use plus, two times I use minus. They are the Java's increment and decrement operators. So as you all know, by default, it increases the operand value by 1 by default. So you might ask me, ma'am, can we do it by 2? No, that's not possible. By default, this is by 1. If you want to increment by 2, then you should use the compound assignment operators. A plus equals to 2. Like this I have to use. But if it is by 1, easily you can use 2 plus 2 minus. Similarly, we have decrement that decreases by 1. Okay. So if I have to write a statement like this, x is equal to x plus 1, I can easily write like x plus plus. No issues. Similarly, if I have to decrement, okay, x is equal to x minus 1, okay, so I can simply write x minus minus. One second. Very simple there. Okay, now these, the special thing about these operators are they appear in both postfix and prefix forms. You can see here it comes in postfix and prefix forms. What is a postfix and prefix? Anybody knows? You think you people have heard about it? Postfix and prefix? Postfix means what? Post means what? Usually English term. Post, pre.
Post is after.
After, pre is before. So it can come in both forms, postfix increment, prefix increment, or postfix decrement, prefix decrement. These forms plays a very different role when used in expressions. When you use it in expressions, their role is quite very different. Normally like this, if you write, both means the same. Just like this you write, both means the same. But when you use inside the expression, they are different. Okay, so let us see what is the different things that happens in the prefix form. As you all know, pre means what? Before. The operand has to be incremented or decremented before the value is obtained for use in the expression. So before you use it, you have to increment or decrement. Post means what? Use it and then modify it. It is whether decrement or increment. Okay, pre means you should increment and then use. Post means use and then increment. Okay, so we have small examples here. I want the answer from your side. Okay, so what is the increment that is happening here? You can see what increment I'm trying to do here.
Student, post increment.
Post increment. So x has taken the value 42 and I'm trying to assign y is equal to x plus plus. Okay. Can anybody give me the answer for x and the answer for y?
Ma'am, y is 42 and then x is 43.
Okay. You can observe now. When I write post, I should use the value and then increment. Okay. So what I do? First I have done like this. Y is equal to x plus plus. What should I do first? First assign it, okay, and then increment the value of x. It is something like this. So this statement will be treated by the compiler like this. First, what does it do, ma? First, what does it do? First, what does it do?
Assign y is equal to 42.
That is, it will assign x to y, okay, and then increments the x value by what? By 1. Yes. So what is the value of y now, students? 42. What is the value of x? 43. As simple as it is. Now, the next example, I'll take the same.
X is, guess
the values of x and y. Carefully answer.
Both are 43, ma'am.
Both are 43. The reason, because it will increment the value of x first and then uses it. Can anybody tell what is this statement treated in the by the compiler? What does it do?
First increment.
Increment x is equal to x plus 1. Then assign the value of x to y like this. Understood? Right? So pre means incremented, then use it. Post means use and then increment. It's like you are prepaid, postpaid. Prepaid means what? You pay and then use. Post is you use and then pay. Like that. So increment happens in this fashion. Don't worry, we have a small example here. I want your side. The output is also displayed. Once again, yes. Okay, so I want the answer from your side. Try, I will, some mechanical students can give me the answer. Prayers has already given. Anybody else from Vijay is there? Vijay? Yes, try giving the answer. Take some time.
I'm first one. A plus.
A value beko.
1 plus 1 plus 1.
How A is obtained? How A is obtained? Justify. What is the value of A? Huh?
From int A is equal to 1.
Okay.
So A is equal to 1 plus 1.
What is the value of A?
1, ma'am. So it will become 1. 2.
Okay, so you mean to say final value of A is
2.
Okay, very good. Let's see whether the answer is correct. Next, what is the value of B? What is the value of B?
Now it will become
B is 2.
Yes, ma'am. B is 2.
What is the value?
Final answer, it will become 3, ma'am.
3. Why? Because you are doing some pre-increment here in this expression. Very good. So it is 3. Let's see. What is the value of C now?
Oh, C, ma'am. Again, it's pre-increment, ma'am.
Okay.
So it will become 4, ma'am.
Okay. How was it 4? Oh, what is the value of C here? Illi en irutte, C value en irutte?
From 2.
2 irutha? Check maadi. What is the value of C here? Take time, don't be in a hurry. What is the value of C here?
Mom, first it will be 2, then it will get incremented and it will become 3.
What is initial, what is the value of C here? Here. What am I doing here is C is equal to plus plus B. What increment is this?
Pre-increment, ma'am.
Increment. It will increment and then use. So what will happen here? C will get what value? C and B both will change to what?
3.
What is the value of C and B? Anybody can answer?
3, ma'am. Huh? 3.
C is 3, ma'am.
3, ma'am. C is 3. 3. The reason because we are using pre-increment to B. See, when I do pre-increment, both will get the same values. Only when I do post, C will differ. See, if it was post here, B plus plus if I would have written, C would have become 2, B would have become 3. Right, post. But since it is pre, both will get the same value. B and C will be 3. Then, you can see here in the below, I have written even C++. Right? It is not an expression, but it is a standalone. What does this mean, ma'am?
Incremented by 1.
What does this mean? 1. C is equal to C plus 1 anta artha. That's it. Okay? It is a standalone. You are not using an expression.
Four.
What is the final value of C now?
4, ma'am.
4, ma'am.
The value of C is 4. Okay. Can anybody guess the value of D?
1, ma'am.
Value of D is? 1?
1, ma'am.
1, ma'am. Okay. Because of that expression, what value of A is changed or not? Because of this expression.
Not yes. Change.
No, ma'am.
You can see B will be 1, whereas A, which was 1, will be incremented by 1 after assigning. So A becomes what value? What is the value of D?
2, ma'am.
D is 1 and A becomes
1.
2 for me. So the output goes like this. A is 2, B is 3, C is 4 and D is 1. Thank you, Vijay, for answering the same. Okay. So you have to analyze it. This is just an example that I have given. So in your, exam, you can give any example, but the output that you write should be correct. So slowly you should illustrate. Okay, see, I have illustrated two things here. One is pre-increment, then next is post-increment, then standalone increment without any expression. Similarly, you can also give for decrement too. Decrement also you can work. Okay, if at all you can give me the answer if it is decrement. Anybody can give me the answer if it is for decrement? Change all this to decrement. What is the value of A, B, C, D if it is decremented? Quickly.
A is 0, ma'am.
A is 0. Oh, I think it's Padmashri or Mehnaz. Who is it?
Padmashri.
Padmashri. Tell me, how is it A 0?
Initially it was 1, but then after when it's get post decremented, A will become 0 and D will be 1.
Yes. So A minus minus, when I write, A it will be used and then decremented. So A will become 0. Okay, next. How about B?
B 1, ma'am. 1.
B is 1. Okay, B is 2. Okay, B becomes 1. And similarly, C will also be 1. Yes. Yes or no?
Zero, ma'am.
Yes,
C is zero.
Then after that, it gets decremented 0.
And further, it will be decremented. Yes, it will become 0. Yes. Okay.
D is 1, ma'am.
D is 1. Yes.
One,
A minus minus. Yes. Okay. So like this, you can have your own examples and work upon the same. Okay. So thank you. We have ended with this today's class. The main motto here was to give you the idea of arithmetic operators. So I have given you, though it looks simpler, probably when you try to put it on the exam paper, it might be difficult. So I want you to practice. So it will be there in your, PPT I'll be putting for module 2 also, whatever I have done for today, kindly go through it. And as I'm telling you, the examples that I give may not be the same for you. You can write your own examples provided it illustrates the concept and gives you the right output. So you have to give the output there. Okay. And I want you people to do some exercise for your next class, that's tomorrow's class. Converting decimal to binary. People know? Converting decimal to binary. Any idea? Someone can answer. Converting decimal to binary.
N power n plus 2.
N power n plus decimal to binary. Okay, if I give you decimal value 3, what is the binary value of 3?
One.
Okay, 1, 1. What is the decimal value of 5?
101. 101.
Okay, so you are answering it as 101 or 11 or whatever it is. How do you get that?
By dividing the base value.
Yes. So I think you people have done that in your normal school classes or your in your normal college classes, previous semesters. I think in your first or second sem you would have dealt with this. I just want you people to know the binary values for the numbers. Okay, probably from 0 to 15 if you know, that's better. Okay, so 0 to 15 you can know. And how to get the binary values for a given number. So if I give you 64, so you should give me the binary value easily. So you know how to be done, 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, and all those things, converting again binary to decimal. So just go through that and come for the next class. That's required for your bitwise operators and all. Okay, one thing. And then second thing is, you know how AND works. AND gate, I think easy people will be familiarized. AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So I just want you people to just go through that. Ma'am. And yes, so you just, we can have. Once again, so I think we can end the class now with one or two questions. Any doubts you have? No? Okay. With one or two questions I'll myself will post. Does modulus operator work on floating in Java?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. It works on floating point.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Oh, what is the answer when you have division given on integer operands? What is the answer you get when you have division on the integer operands? Quickly.
Quotient
value.
Quotient value, wherein
only the integer part.
Only the integer part. Very good. What does modulus give me? I think many are
answering. Reminder part.
Reminder after the division. Yes. Yes. What is the compound assignment operator doing for me in general? What is it trying to do?
Both arithmetic assignment operation.
Yes. So it performs some arithmetic operation and then tries to assign to the same variable. We write a plus 10 can be written as a plus equals to 10. So it does some arithmetic operation and also does the assignment operation. Okay, what are the two different forms of increment and decrement
post
operators?
Post and
pre. Post.
Okay, pre and post. Can anybody tell me what happens in post if it is used in expressions?
The original value is assigned and then it is increased.
After the end of the expression, the value is
assigned. Yes. So instead of telling you are assigning, you can just tell that you are trying to use the value and then try to increment or decrement. Right? That's how it is being done. Use it and then increment or decrement. How about pre? How about pre?
It is incremented and then it is assigned.
Okay. It is incremented and then used. You should tell use.
It's incremented and then used.
Incremented and then used. I think expressions. Okay. Okay, ma'am. Yeah. Thank you. We'll see in the next class with respect to the bitwise operators.
Thank you, ma'am.
Right? So I just want you to go through that conversions and come for the next class. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, students. Thank you.